back in 1971, '72. I never even dreamed of that. No, I thought I was gonna be a truck driver the rest of my life. As a matter of fact, I think about buying a truck.
Yeah. I thought I was gonna be a bricklayer all my life after I quit boxing.
You were boxing?
Oh yeah, for a lot of years. Yeah. A professional sparring partner.
How'd you go from boxing to...
Had my nose broke a couple of times, got married and had kids. That did it.
So then you lay bricks and find out that you need it. Mm-hmm. Release yourself. So after laying the bricks, you play music.
That's right. I already had the music in me. I just didn't have confidence and enough to go out there and pursue it. See, I didn't have that motivation. I had to eat. Being a bricklayer, you know, your hands are all messed up and you're tired all the time. It's a lot of hard work. And you get on stage to play, you feel like an old man, look like an old man. One has to go, you know. Let the brick go and let's try this. And I've prayed for the day. Back in those days, I prayed for the day to come when I would be making the type of money that I am now starving off of.
Show, you read out a list of dedications at the beginning.
Yeah, that's the way I like to do it. Yeah.
Of every set, and even, I think at the end, too?
Mm-hmm.
What's the purpose of that?
Show our appreciation for them coming and to recognize them. Let them know that they are appreciated. They're known. You see, you have to do this. Have to recognize the fact that they are somebody. If it don't be for them, we wouldn't be on that stage. I wish I could call everybody's name in the audience. But man, that'd take a whole gig, you know?
Keeping the beat locked, you know, so everyone follows me, so I have to keep a beat, a straight tempo. You know, I can't be doing nothing too out of proportion. I throw everybody else off, especially the Congo player. You know, he has to follow me.
What are you doing while he's playing that constant beat?
Well, I'm following him to keep the crowd moving. See what I'm saying? And when they break down out of a groove or something, I have to keep the crowd hype. Hype, what I mean is moving, steady moving, dancing. If it's not a death beat, you know, the crowd just gonna stand there and watch. You know, you need to come out with something smooth and make the crowd mainly work with this high congo. That's what, like, that's what get them jumping. This high congo, get them jumping.
I noticed that in every show, there's a point where they just let you go loose.
Okay, well, you know, they'll break it down. He'll stop on his own, you know, and it'll come out the pocket. It'll be.
Around the congo player and the bass drum and the roller tom. It's built around that. So in playing congos, you get to show yourself more.
Because you're constantly moving. Your arms, the beats are fast.
Vigorous.
Yeah.
Does an instrument you get burned out on?
Congos?
Yeah.
If it's a constant beat that you have to keep playing, yes, you will get tired. You won't get burned out, but you get tired.
Now, what about, like, Do the go-go bands use the younger congo players? Because they're like, some bands I think said something about like the older players get a little stale, they're not with the beats that are changing.
Yeah, that's true. Just like Benny, little Benny, new congo player, Jungle Boogie, he been out for a long time. When he was in his younger days, he was the baddest thing out. And, you know, some things went down with him, and now he's back, but he don't have the same momentum that he had when he was young.
We had one that was older. He lost his drive with me, you know, and we replaced him. But we replaced him in a nice way. But, you know, he had started losing it. It was like the timing wasn't there no more. And he'd get tired. And his hands always started hurting, you know.
I play a lot of percussive things on the guitar. While the beat is going on, I do a little thing like, you hear a lot of that in the bossa nova or in sambas and stuff like that, things like that. So I got it, you know, got it from there. Actually, I got it from Chuck Brown, but that's where, you know.
What else do you do? What other kinds of things do you do with guitar?
Well, I do a lot of things about like the other guitar players, old guitar players are doing. They do a lot of just running up and down the strings, whether it be something like doing that irritating sound right there, all of that, we incorporate all of that into what we're doing.
Everything's built around the beat, you know, the drum beat and percussion, bongos. So everything, every song is like, it's played with a different beat.
Basic top 40 song, you want me to play it?
Sure.
A basic top 40 song is like, say you what, you know, something simple like that. As far as it's go-go, the basic go-go beat that all bands do is, and right now, you know, the style changes as the year's going. Right now, at this time, the beat is like a more laid back beat, you know. People kind of groove more to that beat. They're more like a fast tempo beat. Fast tempo is really like the top 40.
Wasn't it a faster tempo with when Chuck Brown was doing like We Need Some Money and stuff like that?
Yeah, when you do a record in go-go, they kind of speed the tempo up, you know, in most bands. I guess it blends in with more radio music, I guess.